Yes, we're not as snappy as poetry. Kabow! We say words and music in the woods. Words and music in the woods. That's the night I host. I don't run it. Ironically, it's on tonight. This is the first Thursday of the month. So Murray, who owns the place and runs it, is doing it now. And Judy Mullen is guest hosting because I'm here. And Ceri May is always there, and a fine poet, and is a crouchender, so she's very, she's local. A lot of poets come up to the mic and complain about things they don't like. Oh, I don't like that. Another thing I don't like is wearing a hat. Some people do and some people don't care. Some people will and some people won't wear a hat indoors. It can cause disapproval and calls for its removal. Or it can generate little ripples of applause. On the other hand, you might be ambivalent and indifferent about the indoor tipper. After all, everyone's wearing one at a bar mitzvah. But people are starting rumours, because they see me and assume as how I've always got a hat to put my head in. It's okay to go around spreading that I'm obviously dreading come the day I put my bald head on display. No way! I love my head this way, all smooth and hairless. Call me baldy if you like, I really couldn't care less. In truth, her suit never suited me. You can see your reflection in my spherical crest, and ladies, getting sex on with a slap head is the best. Cause when I canoodle on down, giving you a licking, unlike hairy men, you've got something to doodle on. Now it sounds astounding, if I love my shiny bots, how come I'm always found in fancy hats to ponce around in? Well, it's not to keep my billiard bald head all hidden in a sheath. No, it's to cover up the embarrassing, tiny, pathetic little hat I'm wearing underneath. It's called No More Nails. It's a breakup poem about a bunny boiler, really. And you have to suspend disbelief about the age difference here. It's not so much Alan Wolfson as Woody Allen. It's called No More Nails, or you can't mend a broken heart with an epoxy resin-based polyvinyl chloride adhesive. I was shocked like a sonic boom when she broke up with me. I thought she was joking. No, she wasn't. She was joking. I was shocked like a sonic boom when she broke up with me. I thought she was joking, so I locked her in my room.
I had to break a window to escape.
But I was waiting. I said, first you break my heart, then you break my glass, you bastard.
I came back with a curt. Just let me go, you want me to fix the window? Fine, I'll fix the fucking window.
I declined with all the histrionic disgust I could muster. I don't want your putty. Yeah, I told her.
I just shrugged my shoulders, shook my head and said, you look like a wreck.
Well, yeah, what do you expect when you've broken my heart?
Oh, dear. How clumsy of me. I was aiming for your neck.
I snapped. I held a glue gun to her head and said, if all else fails, I'll stick us both together with no more nails.
Yeah, well, I'll prize us both apart with no more screw. Listen, as much as I'd love to be conjoined at the base, I'm going to have to ignore you.
That's when I threatened to self-harm, but she protested.
No, don't self-harm. Please let me do it for you.
I swore I'd settle this score. I'll write a warning poem. I'll mark you dangerous to all men. You'll never get to kiss one.
Okay, then. Write your poem. Here, borrow my pen. But I fucking hope it's better than this. Right tense. Bye, Grandma. On the removal of clothing as an act of love. Just as she was about to take her top off, he cried, wait, not yet. I want to hold on to the moment when I first see you whole. I'm too drunk now. And so she took his hand and told him stories through all the night. There was the story of her birth. The story about the beginning of her spider phobia, which arose in a log cabin in summer. The story of the scar upon her wrist. The story about the end of her spider phobia, which occurred in a dream in winter. There were several stories of broken hearts, and also some of hearts mended with wine and ribbon and glue and time. She softened her voice a little, embellished the characters somewhat, but almost all of her stories were true. And in the sober light of morning, she let go of his hand, removed her clothes, and he saw her in all her wholeness for the second.